Yo, what's up guys, coming here from Addictive Frames. In this video, I'm going to show you how to create this motion graphic animation in DaVinci Resolve. Okay, so let's create that. Okay guys, here we are in DaVinci Resolve, straight in Fusion, and this is the node tree, this is the composition that I created for this animation. You will have all assets, I mean not all assets, but just this composition. I thought it doesn't make sense to provide you the asset if you can download it from FlatIcon, which is this website, so you just need to type in whatever icon you want to place in this animation. So let's say broken car. There you go, that's exactly the icon I used in this animation. Okay, let's go to the edit page and open another Fusion composition and create this animation from scratch. So I'm gonna go with the same length and I'm going to open this Fusion composition. First of all, we need a reference, so you will have a reference as well. Let's put this reference to the left viewer so we can see how does it go, and we're gonna follow that. So first of all, we need to create background. I've got background created already, so I just drag it here and show you what I've got here inside. Let's put it on the right side, and as you can see, we start with white, simple white, no, that's simple, but f5 f5 f5, that's the hex code for this background. Next is grid with these parameters, and settings we've got 0.1, and that's connected to the merge, and here we've got transparent background. Okay, let's go, let's connect this background node tree to media out, and let's start with this guy. He's going to be in the middle, relaxation. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna type in center icon. Okay, so at the beginning of the animation, it will appear like that. It's normal smooth size animation, but we're gonna create something better, something else. Let's grab transparent background. Let's connect it to the background. Okay, let's connect to this node tree, connect that to the background. And as you can see, it's a bit too big. So let's grab transform here and make it a bit smaller. So let's say we're gonna keep like 0.5 maybe. Yeah, it's all right. And below this merge, I'm gonna grab another transform. I'm gonna make it bigger. I'm gonna name it transform elastic. And now I'm going to go to size and I'm going to modify with land now effects. And this is motion pal. This is tool, paid tool. I highly recommend that tool. It's not very expensive. I use that very often. So I'm gonna show you how it works. You can download it from this website. You're gonna have link in description below. So I'll show you how easy it is to set every animation. So what you need to do, you need to go to modifier of this transform. You just need to go to animation down, and we are on frame zero, and animate that, and you go to the full of animation and it's animated already. So we need to go to browse curves. So we've got all of curves, as you can see, which makes our life so much easier. And now I want this as is out elastic, this one. Okay, it's not working because I know why, because on the first frame I put just this number one. So it needs on first frame needs to be number zero, and I want to go to frame number 100 and change this animation to one. So I want to turn off high quality and motion blur for smooth, for better performance. And as you can see, it's nice elastic appearance of this icon. I'm going to grab background with alpha zero, and I'm going to grab another background. I'm going to connect that to the main node tree when I connect these backgrounds to each other. For now, let's make this not working. Hotkeys for that is Control P. It's not visible for now. So now we've got only background and our new node tree, which we're gonna create now. So background, I'm gonna make alpha one, and I want to make this color, and I'm gonna name it, that's gonna be BG red. After that, we need ellipse. So ellipse, I've got expression here in height, so I'll show you how it works. So I will remove this expression. It's simple, so in height, you hit expression and connect it to the width. So when you change width, it's all go along together. And this ellipse, let's leave it like that. And next, we're gonna copy this background and paste it here as instance. And we're gonna connect this instance here, okay? I'm gonna copy this ellipse and paste it here and connect it to this instance of background. And with this instance, I'm going to the instance level, and I'm going to the instance solid, as well as border width and soft edge. So first of all, I'm going to go to level of this ellipse on the left, and I'm going to type in here in level 0.2. And coming back to this instance, I'm going to uncheck solid, and I'm going to increase border width. Let's unfix our view control so we can see what what's going on here. So let's leave it in these parameters. In first ellipse, we're going to go to soft edge like that, and we're going to increase border width, and I'm going to increase that to 0.4. And now I'm going to copy this instance, copy that, paste it here below merge, below this merge as instance. So that's going to be instance of instance. And with this instance, I'm going to this the instance border width, and I'm going to check solid. And now I'm going to connect that here, this merge. So this ellipse is closed. And actually, this is it. And now we can, when we move width of any of ellipse, it will go together, okay? Because they connected as ellipse. Okay, you could see this cut edges because this composition getting to quite heavy. And now I want to add our icons, I mean one icon to this node tree. So first of all, let's grab tooth, okay? So let's name it, that's gonna be tooth. And I want to connect this to here, to this node tree. Okay, and I need for that color corrector, yeah. And you can have these parameters as I have. And I always repeat that, make sure you check pre-divide, post-multiply, go back to correction, and I'm gonna double click on gain. And I want to add transform here. So I want to increase size of that. Let's close media pool. And now we need to use this second instance, connect it to this merge. So now this node tree, so this tooth, is masked by this instance, which is solid, okay? It's not outlined. I will name every node in a minute, but I want to show you how it works. So this ellipse with lower level of, I don't know, this is like opacity, but this is just level. It's the same. So this is masked by this instance. Okay, anyway, so let's come back to the size as it was. So let's rename some nodes to not to get lost. So this is, let's name it ellipse opacity. Let's name this ellipse outline. This is outline, and that's ellipse mask. Okay, let's make more space. Okay, and actually, as you can see on the left, yeah, in reference, there is some numbers at the top of every icon. So we need a room in Canva here. So we make this smaller. So let's make it like 0.35. And as well, we need to decrease size of icon. And we're gonna add number below. So I've got number ready. Okay, and we've got this. We won't need background for this animation. This is merge, and I will show you in a minute how it works. And this is number. This is tool which you can download from YouTube. Just type in Patrick's Steel Link numbers, and from here you can have this tool for free. And as you can see, when we go to frame number 0 and we go to this merge, so blend is 0. When we go to frame 50, it's not only this, but on frame 0 center, you have center Y 0.47 animated. And when we go to frame 50, this come back to 0.5 and blend is in 1. As you can see, it will appear nicely, the number. You can see it here. So I'm gonna go with that on the top. I'm gonna increase the size. Let's do it 0.7, and let's change number to, let's leave it for 100. What I've changed here is just in element 2, I've changed the color, so let's go with red as well. Then I change around to 0.122, and I think that's it. So yeah, on frame 0 I animated this merge, and dollars, it starts on 0, on frame number 0, in value select you've got 0, and in frame number 36 you've got the value, which will be the outcome. So in animation, as you can see, when icon come out from the guy in the middle, this element's getting to be desaturated. So for that animation we need a color corrector. And what I want to do, I want to go to frame, let's say 200. And actually, I'm going to double click on everything. I've got in default this parameter. So I want to go with saturation, like from frame 199 to, let's say, go plus 50 frames. Saturation will go down. So after color corrector, when it is animated to be desaturated, we're going to have a transform. And this transform, I'm going to name it positioner. And we're gonna position by this transform, we're gonna position every element in Canva. But before we're gonna do that, we go into decrease the size of of our elements. So first of all, we're gonna go to, I supposed to do that earlier, but I forgot. So we're gonna decrease even more. So let's see, show view controls, and then we can compare the size to our original animation. And this is how we're going to adjust the size. So as you can see, this is 0.1, correct. And we're gonna grab the numbers to that as well. That's gonna be on the top. So the number is supposed to be about 0.4. Okay, let's put it here. And as well as the icon, it needs to be smaller. You can hold Alt and manipulate the position. Okay, cool. So we've got elements prepared already, and now we can copy all of the node tree. So let's go with that. Let's copy, and we need 6 elements. Paste it here, here. And let's guys connect it to the main node tree. So now we can position every element. Let's go first positioner. So this is the tooth. It's gonna be all the tooth, but let's position them. So I'm going to put some of there. So now I want to see this guy in the middle. So let's put it back to life and position everything like that. We're gonna change the numbers in a minute. Number supposed to be smaller, but they don't have to. Let's leave it like that. And now we're going to replace all icons. So in number 2, it doesn't matter which one is where. Home repair number 2. There we go. The next step is we need to create this coin animation. So the coin is coming up from behind this guy. They needs to be behind. We're gonna make space here for this coin. For this purpose, we're gonna grab background with alpha 0, and I'm gonna grab coin. Let's name it coin. I'm gonna connect it here, and I want to see that in the left, and I need the color corrector for that. Okay, let's look like that, and I want glow for that as well. It needs to be shiny. Money needs to be shiny, something like that. I want to position this money, this coin, behind the guy, and size as well. So I'm gonna grab transform just below the merge, and I want to put it down like that. And what we're gonna do now is we're gonna follow the reference. Okay, so let's go with reference on the left, and let's go to the coins. And now I want to make this transform bigger, and I'm gonna name it coin movement. So when the guy will appear and all the elements next to him will appear as well, I want this money to get opacity on just before it will start to move towards the elements. I'm talking about coin. So let's go to the merge. I'm gonna name it opacity as well. I'm gonna make it bigger. So before they started to move, I want this opacity to be blend 0 and go one frame further. And I'm gonna go back with blend to 1. And next, let's start to move the coin. So let's start from frame 200, and let's use this transform and animate center. And let's go with, I don't know, 40. Exactly, 40 is okay. So 40 frame further. So that's gonna be frame number 240. And I want to move this coin. Let's go to the path first. Okay, and let's smooth it out, and let's go with is out cubic. And actually, I'm gonna rename coin movement, that will be 1. And before we do anything further, so let's name every element. Okay, when you name all your elements, now you need to adjust keyframes from coin to the color corrector animation. So if this coin was moved to the pet, we need to select this coin movement to pet, okay? And let's go to the color corrector and select this color corrector. Remember that transform of coin is selected as well. So as you can see in Inspector, I've got color corrector selected and coin movement as well. So I'm going to go to keyframes tab, and I will open that. And as you can see, when the coin is going there, the pet is going to be desaturated. So all you need to do now, you need to copy all of this money movement. Let's put the background there. So let's copy this, and we need the 6 of that. And actually, we need to copy that with merge as well. Copy, paste it here, holding shift, connect it to the main node tree, and do that with every one. We need the 6 coins. I'm going to rename all of them. That's going to be coin movement number 2, coin movement number 3, and up to 6. I'm going to select them. go to keyframe tab and expand control tools, and I'm going to go with that like that. So when this coin is finished, the next one will start, okay? I mean, the first one finished and next one will start like that. You can go along the speech. We don't have any voiceover here, so I'm gonna just create as I want. And after that, I want to go to each coin, to transform of each coin. I mean, the node which we named coin movement, we need to go to, so that will start frame 239 and that will finish 40 frames later. So we're gonna grab in here. So next one will be transform and coin movement number 3. Let's go to the end of animation. And the next one will be, let's say, broken car. Coin number 4 is going to go to tooth. And number 5 will go tax. And number 6, it will go to house. And now what you need to do, you need to go to coin movement number 2. So we're going to looking for smartphone. You have it here. And remember, this transform coin movement 2 is selected. So holding control, you need to select color corrector of smartphone. You need to go to keyframe of that. You need to expand tool controls and you need to adjust keyframe that. So color corrector needs to be adjusted to coin movement. And as you can see, it works well. Okay. And you need to do that with everyone. And actually what I forgot to do is I forgot to animate ellipse opacity at the beginning. So let's go to frame number 50. Let's go to opacity of ellipse opacity. I just name it like that, but it's not opacity. And let's animate with and go to the each one of that, do the same. Now we go into frame number 0 and that will go to 0 width on each ellipse. And now let's select all ellipse opacity, go to spline editor and let's select all of the points, hit F, T, and actually no, sorry, Shift L, and we go into is out cubic for that. It is choppy in my computer. I don't know how about you, but all animation is done. So what we need to do, we need to render that on edit. So we need to wait until this red line turned to blue to see our result. I think this is because of plenty of modifiers in this composition. However, if you want to be precise now, we don't follow any voiceover, but that was for my client. She was talking about emergency fund, that you need to have some emergency money in case of something happened surprisingly in your life, like a smartphone can be broken, or car, or your pet will be ill. So you need to just change the numbers here, because obviously to treat your pet won't cost you $100,000. Change all the numbers. That's what is left in this animation. And that's it, guys. Thank you so much for watching this video. Thank you. Stay with me till the end. If you want to learn more about animation in Fusion, about motion graphing, how to create that kind of animation, I recommend watching this video next. See you there, guys.